Belarusian women of the past. Yes, some of them are writers, some of them are part of royal families, and some of them are just nuns, as you can see. And they actually did a lot to our society. But in schools, we are taught that these women, they sacrifice themselves for the better future of our country, of men, of a family. And that's actually a really bad thing, I think, to my opinion, because little girls start to adopt this construct. And our society actually do this too, and start introduce the idea of sacrificing yourself to women, to little girls. And that creates a lot of problems, because when we start talking about domestic violence in Belarus, we start seeing this sacrificing. I worked with women who are victims of domestic violence, and they told me that they can't leave their abuser. They need to save their family, they can't ruin life of their children, and so on. And as you know or not, Belarus didn't ratify the Istanbul Convention action against violence against women and domestic violence, and our government didn't criminalize domestic violence at all. So if you want to write an application and send it to police office and say that I am a victim of domestic violence, no one will help you, and said that it's not actually true. And we have a lot of sayings, like folk literature, and there is a saying, it's rather popular, and I haven't found the equivalent in English, but I will translate it like it is, that they could say to you that when man hits you, he shows that he loves you. And that's horrible, actually, because it's not true. It's horrible. It's violence. And people, even society, use it. And women in Belarus, they faced violence and just get used to it, because they are afraid of a society who will blame women for just telling that they are the victims. And we have a lot of these things. Our government told in public that you shouldn't talk about your problems in your home, outside your home. So it's only related to you, even it's violating your rights. And it's and we live in this environment and fighting for our rights. And I guess it's the aim number one for Belarusian women to criminalize domestic violence and stop sacrificing ourselves for something.